So if you look at what was happening with the Corvettes, you cannot deny the tribute that we can give to Dave MacDonald here today.
Yeah.
We've got Sherry here so that we can, you know, honor directly what accomplishments that Dave MacDonald did. We have his son, Rich, right over here. Rich. And we have Dave's brother, Doug, right here.
Hey, Doug.
And the sister, Dave.
Daughter.
Okay.
Vicky,
no one introduced me. Okay, there you are. All right, raise your hand up there. So after that race that we're going to say, the week prior he won at Riverside,
right.
Then he comes up with this hardship in Laguna Seca and wins that race. What was the next race, Sherry? Where'd you guys go after that?
We went to the Hawaiian Grand Prix. Is that the one you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's something I've never heard of, Hawaiian Grand Prix. Okay.
Neither did we. We didn't know about it either until Shelby came out. He said, you guys are going to Hawaii.
Oh,
and I just read it. Where's that at?
He said,
just don't be a smart ass. Get your gangsters together and get the cars ready. That was Shelby's favorite saying to me. Because I got one gangster left right there. Feel free to.
Well, I'm not used to public speaking like all these guys up here. So when you told me that I was going to tell the Hawaiian Grand Prix story, I wrote it. So I'm going to read it to you. That way I won't leave anything out. This was in October of 1963. Dave had just won the LA Times Grand Prix and the Monterey Pacific Grand Prix in the King Cobra. The same King Cobra that's right outside, Bill and Evelyn Hartman brought it down just for this event. These were pretty prestigious races back then with all the best cars and all the best drivers. So Carroll was pumped. He was on cloud nine after the victories. So as a treat to his team, he added the Hawaiian Grand Prix to the schedule and took everybody to Hawaii. Dave and I were really excited because we'd never been to Hawaii. Craig Lang, the heir to Olympia Brewing, traveled with the team. Craig was a part-time club racer, a pretty good one, and had a home on Oahu at that time. More importantly, he was negotiating with Carroll to buy and build a King Cobra, which would be run under the Shelby banner. Ford had given Carroll a ton of support on the Cobra Roadsters, but they put a limit of two on the King Cobras. So Carroll, obviously, welcomed the idea of a third King Cobra, compliments of Craig Lang. Craig's only stipulation was that Dave be the driver and Wally be the crew chief. So Carroll entered three cars in the Hawaiian Grand Prix, two Cobra Roadsters and one King Cobra. Even though the King Cobra was the one Dave won in at Riverside and Laguna Seca, Carroll decided it was Craig Lang who was going to drive it in Sunday's big race. Dave and Ken Miles would drive the Cobra Roadsters. So on Saturday night, Dave prepared me for what was going to happen the next day. He told me that Craig was going to win the main event. And I said, why? I always felt that if Dave could win a race, he should win the race. But Dave told me, nope, not this time. He said Craig was the hometown boy, and it would be great for him to win. Besides, the Hawaiian Grand Prix was a non-championship race, so there were no manufacturer points or driver points at stake. I did not agree with the strategy, and my arguments got me absolutely nowhere. So on race day, the Shelby team gave the Hawaiian crowd a great race. Craig had the pole in the King Cobra, and he took the lead with Dave and Kim right behind him. On lap five, Dave passed Craig and led for 22 laps, much to my delight. Then Craig passed Dave, and he took the checkered flag 13 laps later. Always the showman, though, Ken and Dave had hatched a plan prior to the race. Craig was going to win, but they planned to cross the finish line side by side. Craig's in front, with Dave and Ken riding his bumper. So picture this. Here's the three of them coming right down to the finish line. And that is the way they finished. Craig won by 1 second. Dave actually came in second place, but what was described as a thin coat of paint. So at the end of the day, the spectators were happy. They'd seen a great race. Craig was happy because he'd driven the King Cobra to victory in front of the hometown crowd. Carroll was happy because his Cobras came in 1, 2, 3. Everything had gone as planned. I was the only one who didn't get my way, but I wound up happy too. I'm sure many of you remember Dave's big grin. After the race, all he had to do was look down at me, give me that big endearing grin, and I was happy too.
I'm glad that you shared that story with us. Obviously, that was something that happened. Very unique, that a lot of people probably haven't heard about, but it's obviously very special. And it also shows that Dave was willing to, you know, give and go out there and let Craig win the race. So he didn't always have to be number one all the time.
That was me.